Hello and welcome, my dear third standard students. How are you all? I hope you are good, you are fine, and now you have started your preparation hard and fast for your SM1 exams. My dear little gems, I know that you are preparing well and you have become consistent in your work. You are sending your work regularly to the follow-up teachers, and some of them are even sending it to me and to follow-up teachers, both of them. Not only that, but also few students are sending regular thoughts to me, so I like to appreciate them all for their hard work, and obviously they are going to get the fruitful result as they have been consistently doing their work. So my dear students, as you know that in the previous lecture we have finished the worksheets of chapter number 7. Now not only worksheets, but we have finished all the theory part, two worksheets and the test paper also. So my dear students, as you know that lastly we have done chapter number 7. So this time, in this lecture, or I should say from this lecture, we are going to start the revision of chapter number 6. So we will go from the back side to the front side, that is we are going to go anti-clockwise. Now as soon as we have finished chapter number 7 worksheet and all that, now we are going to start chapter number 6. So I hope that you all are ready for solving it, for revising it with me. And as you know that once you have already written chapter number 6, now you have to write it down in your rough notebook for the revision purpose. So let's get started, and this is the golden opportunity for those who are not having the theory part of chapter number 6. Now you can write it down. So let us start our day with a wonderful thought given by Bojani Sayeda. So Sayeda, first of all, I really thank you for sharing such a wonderful thought, for keeping in touch with all the thoughts you are sending us. It's really wonderful job done by you. Thought of the day is, tomorrow is too late. Yesterday is over. Now is the exactly right moment, so start. So it is a great thought given by Sayeda. Sayeda is telling that tomorrow will be too late. So if you will keep everything on tomorrow, it will become too late. And yesterday, it is already gone. We can do nothing of yesterday. What exactly the time is? Now you have. What you can do, perfect thing is, at the right time you are having. So never keep everything on tomorrow, or don't be dependent or pay attention on what is gone. Now what you have, you can just manipulate the way it is. So I hope that you understood this thought, and now you will work on in the moment which is there, the time which is there in your hand, and not what is gone and what is going to come. So Sayeda, once again I really appreciate your efforts regularly sending me the thoughts. So I am also looking forward for many such students for sending me the thoughts. So my dear students, now I hope that you are ready with your rough notebook. If you are ready with your rough notebook, start giving the heading as we regularly do. You know that first of all we write the date, today's date you have to write, then the subject, and then you have to write today chapter number 6 revision, which I will write it now. So I'm going to clear the board and give the heading, and I'll wait for you for the couple of seconds so that you can give the heading properly. So give the heading chapter 6. Revision. Please give the heading like I have instructed you. I'll wait for a couple of seconds for you to finish giving the heading. First and the foremost thing what we are going to discuss here in this revision lecture is fill in the blanks, and then true or false. So those who are not having this data, this theory of chapter number 6, please write it down even in your fair book. Whole lot of students have already completed their fair book and sending me the photographs, but this is for the exceptional cases for those who are not having the theory part. They are just sending me the messages that sir, please send PDF of chapter 6 and 7. Now see, 7th chapter is already done in the previous few lectures. If you have not done, please watch the lectures. Rather than asking for the PDF, if you watch the lectures, it is better for you. And now chapter 6 we are going to start. So those who are not having, please do watch the lectures regularly now onwards. Also, I will suggest you to watch the previous lectures in which I have given you the class test which you can appear for in the limited time. I have made the two class tests in the previous two lectures, which was for chapter 5, 6 and 7. So it would be better if you watch the lectures, live lectures. You will be able to connect yourself with the topic more rather than just jotting down the questions and answers from the PDF. So I hope that you have given the heading by now. Let us start with filling the blanks. So as simple as that, in all the lectures, what in the way we are doing is writing the questions and then me waiting for you to complete the questions and then I'll write the answer. In the same manner we are going to work here in this lecture as well. So I hope that you will start writing the questions with me. First of all, we are going to give the heading fill in the blanks. That is FB. Now you people have to write the full form, that is fill in the blanks. So I'm going to write the questions and wait for you to write down the question and then I'll write the answers. Yes, if you know the answers and if you have the time left, you can just write the answers on your own and then compare your answers with the answers written on the board. So let's start writing the questions here on the now. Number one. I hope, my dear students, you have started writing the questions with me. So I have written 5 questions of fill in the blanks. I hope that you have started writing and soon you will finish writing the questions. I am going to wait for a couple of seconds more for you to complete writing the questions. So my dear students, there were only 5 fill in the blanks and I hope that those who have completed their fair book, they might be knowing that there are only 5 fill in the blanks in this chapter which you had to write it in your fair notebook. So those whose fair book is incomplete, even for them, this is going to be very, very helpful. Now, I'm going to read 5 questions till you are writing it in your books. Question number 1 is, dashed plants and animals are living things. Question number 2 is, animals move from one place to another in search of dashed. Number 3, dashed plants make their own food. Number 4, plants breathe through the tiny holes called dashed. Number 5, dashed things do not move on their own. Now actually there is a small correction here. It should be things. And here it is. So I hope that you will finish writing the questions soon, so that we will be able to write the answers. And those who, like I said, that those who are knowing the answers already, they have learned it and understood it, they can write the answers, and then later when I write it on the board, they can just compare their answers with the answers written on the board. Now even like I said, like I've been telling you in many lectures, I have told you that you have to even check your spellings for the answers, like fill in the blanks, and these all are the answers which you have to write just in a one word. And still if you make the mistake in that one word, obviously we are going to deduct your marks. So I hope that you have almost finished writing the questions. Few more seconds and then I'm going to write on the board the answers I'm going to write. So after this we are going to write true or false, which you have to write on the new page though you are writing it in your rough book. Okay my dear students, I hope that you have written the questions, and now let us write the answers for these fill in the blanks and let us revise it. Now question 1 is, dashed plants and animals are the living things. Can you say that the selected plants and selected animals are the living things? No. Every plant and every animal, they have the lives within. So they all are the living things. So all is the answer here. All plants and animals are living things. Though plants cannot move from one place to another, they cannot travel, but still plants have the lives. And in short, plants and animals both are the living things. So all the plants and animals are living things. So I hope that you have written the answer now. And for those who have already written the answer, please compare your answers and check your answers. Number 2, animals move from one place to another in search of dash. Now, if you have understood the chapter while I was explaining you, chapter number 6, why do animals move from one place to another place? Just to do the walking? Just to maintain their health? No. So why do they move? In search of what? In search of food and in search of shelter. So food and shelter is the answer. Food and shelter. Please write down the answers if you have not written. If you have written, check your answers, check the spellings as well. Number 3. Dashed plants make their own food. Now, which plants make their own food? Red plants or blue plants? No. Green plants make their own food. So, green is the answer here. Green plants make their own food because they have chlorophyll present in it. So, it is green. And through the process of photosynthesis, taking in the sunlight, air and water in the proper amount, they make their food. So that is it. Now the next is number 4. Plants breathe through the tiny holes called dash. Now as we have the tiny holes like a nose in the form of nose. So we call it nose. But which is the nose of the plants? They have the tiny holes through which they breathe. Now what exactly is that part of the plant called? It is called stomata. Stomata. I hope that you have written the answers, and I should just hope that maximum students have written the answer before I have written on the board. Number 5. Things do not move on their own. So which things cannot move on their own? Can I move on my own? Yes, I am moving from one place to another. I am living thing. So can this marker move from one place to another if I don't pick up? No. So this is the non-living thing. So non-living thing cannot move on their own. So non-living things do not move. So things is already written. We just have to write non-living. Please have a look on the answers. Write down the answers. Now, as you can see, in brief, I have just explained you the answers again, as while explaining you the lesson, worksheets and everything we have already done. Still, just to recall the topics again for you, I have done that. Answer. So the blank number 1 is all plants and animals are the living things. Number 2 is animals move from one place to another in search of food and shelter. Number 3 is green plants make their own food. Number 4 is plants breathe through the tiny holes called stomata. So the spelling is also the same, stomata. It's very easy to remember. Number 5 is non-living things do not move on their own. I hope that you have written the answers. If you had already written it, I hope that you have checked it. So with this, our revision of fill in the blanks is over. Now we're going to revise true or false of the same chapter. So on the new page, give the heading, give the topic heading, true or false. Please write the full form. And in the same way, we will just write the questions first and then solve it and write the answers. So I'm going to clear the board and write the questions for true or false. I hope that you are ready with your pencils in the hand. Okay, so the next topic is true or false. Like I said, that you have to write on the new page. Though you are writing in the rough book, you have to write it on the new page. Leaving one line, obviously, like you have written fill in the blanks. You have to leave one line for true or false as well. So let's write the questions first of all. Number 1. Number 2. I hope, my dear friends, you have started writing the questions. So this is going to be the last question, question number 5 for true or false. So my dear students, I have written 5 questions for true or false. I hope that you have also started writing it.
So these 5 questions are very easy to be solved. Question number 1 is, living things need food, shelter and air to live. Number 2, non-living things do not eat, drink or breathe. Number 3, all plants and animals move from one place to another. Number 4, leaves of touch me not plant open up when touched. And number 5, only plants can grow with time. I hope that you are writing the questions.
There are only 5 true or false statements or sentences or questions in this chapter. For those who have already written in their fair notebook, they might be knowing that. And again, I'd like to say that those who have not completed their fair book or the notes are incomplete for chapter number 6, this is the great opportunity. Please write it down even in your fair book.
So soon we are going to write the answers for these questions. Solve it. And as you can see, I have kept the blank space for writing whether the statement is true or false at the end of the each statement. You can too write it down like that. And not to forget that you have to leave one line after each question. That is the reason why I have asked you to write it down or start writing it from the new page. So now my dear students, I'm going to write the answers for these true or false. So I hope that you all are ready with your questions, and I think that few students have or might have written the answers already. Let's see what the answers are. Number 1 is, living things need food, shelter, air to live. So you and me, we both are the living things. Do we need air? Yes. Then do we need the food? Yes, we need the food. Do we need the shelter? Yes. So we are the living things. We need all these things. Obviously, then this statement is true. Next one is, non-living things do not eat, drink or breathe. Non-living things do not eat, drink or breathe. Now this marker is non-living thing. Does it need the water? Food? No. So this statement is true because it is written that non-living things do not eat, do not drink or do not breathe. So this statement also is true. Make sure that you have to understand the statements, because in the exam perhaps the question will be twisted even in the true or false or in the objectives, all the objectives. Number 3, all the plants and animals move from one place to another. I know that here, this is the question where whole lot of students have made the mistake and will make the mistake. Why?
Because in simple language it is written that all plants and animals, and in the previous exercise where filling the blanks was there, there the answer was all. All plants and animals are the living things. But like I said that here the question you have to read it twice. All the plants and animals move from one place to another? No, this is false. Why? Because animals do move from one place to another, but plants cannot move. So this statement is false. Then the next question is, leaves of touch me not plant open up when touched? No, the name of the plant is touch me not. So if you touch that plant, the leaves closes. Now here it is written that when you touch, it opens up. Obviously this statement is also therefore false statement. Then the next question is, only plants can grow with time. Only plants or trees can grow. We do not grow. We also grow. Not only us, animals also. So every living thing grow with the time. So this statement also is false. So I hope that you have written the answer. If not, please write it down.
So my dear students, I have explained you the reason if the statement is true, then why it is true, and if the statement is false, why is it false. That is the reason why I have explained you, and it is very essential for you to understand the statement, because like I said that in the exam perhaps I can change the question. So please make sure you prepare accordingly. So with this I end my today's lecture. I hope that you enjoyed this revision of both the objectives, fill in the blanks as well as true or false. In the next lecture, I will bring the next part of the revision for the same chapter. So be ready with it. Keep sending your work to your teachers. Not to forget that. Have a nice day. Goodbye.